way of me storytelling what, like, the struggles I've gotten through in my artist career and my life as a person. When I was studying in China at the Central Academy of Fine Arts, it was a really interesting learning experience because obviously the way of teaching art was very different from how they teach art in Australia. It was very technique focused and was very structural. Everything was like marked as well. So, there was a sense of, there was a bit of like public humiliation, I have to admit, because since everything was marked out of 100 and all the marks were posted on like a board. And I'm always like kind of curious, like how do you mark a work of art, you know? How do you mark it out of 100, like for and be sure that it's the right mark? It's such a subjective piece of work when everyone's technique is quite good, but everyone has also the unique style. And it's kind of like part of what inspired a part of my current project as well, is this idea of pride and shame and like the perception of others in our society and how we try to like mold ourselves to what our parents kind of want us to be or what society think is ideal, and these kind of like opinions affect our own ideas of what is ideal and kind of try and push ourselves to that image. So for me, like the glass armour is a symbol of that ego that is built by society and the ideal that we try to strive for. But it's because it's an ideal, you can't really embody it. It's not really us, right? So when there's like situations where you feel ashamed, you also like feel this sense of isolation because you don't want to shatter that image that other people have of you. So you kind of like keep to yourself and really isolate yourself from any ideal help, and that's like caused a lot of depression among, like, I think people in general, but I felt extremely, it was also, I felt it very, very sharp during my time in China when I was studying and I was kind of seeing my marks, and even though I wasn't doing too bad, but I was like, I've never got an 80% with art. So I was, it was like, there was a bit of a shock and there was like this idea of loss of face, and it also like carried across into my personal life as well. So like this work, I guess, is a way of me confronting that. So the first year that which was the year that I did in Carfor was painting and sketching, and I still retain those skills. But I've always wanted to work with glass, and at the time they didn't have a glass studio. But I found that these like kind of skills have been really invaluable to me. Like it was tough like studying there, but it was also it was really good in terms of developing my skills as an artist. I found it really invaluable. And the way that I was studying the culture there as well, when I was studying, I was being influenced by their ideas of Taoism and being getting really interested in the historical side of China. I was able to visit a lot of temples and kind of hear these kind of small stories along the lines, and then I kind of did further research into them. But it definitely, like studying painting and sketching, like kind of influenced how I sculpt, because I think like sculpture is a 3D sketch. You, as long as you know, I always start off with a sketch when I'm doing a sculpture, just to understand what the form is and how to go about sculpting it. Because like, and I think it's vice versa for sculptors as well when they're doing a sketch. It's like a 2D sculpture for them. So my current series is about the human struggle with emotions and the ego. ego and pride. It's something that I personally experience, but also kind of relates to my culture. So with the glass armour series, I wanted to go back in time and talk about some of the stories in Chinese history. For example, Guan Yu and Zhang Fei, who were like two heroes during the Three Kingdoms period, which I'm really fascinated by, and the kind of rise and fall within the world. How they rose to power and how they fell was because of their strengths, which were also their weaknesses. Like, I want to examine the things that drive us and where the balance is in terms of the advantages and disadvantages of the things that motivate us. For me, I work a lot with symbolism. I use glass because it's kind of a material that is not just beautiful, but it has a lot of connotations to it. So people see glass and immediately they have their own projected ideas of what glass is, like the fragility, the transparency, the preciousness. And I like to work with those kind of elements in my storytelling. I want to work with what their ideas of glass is, with my concepts on as well. When I work really structured, it just doesn't work because things are always going wrong in the glass studio, like the casts. For example, my process with cast glass, it's a really lengthy process, and it could go wrong at any point in time where I have to go back and start from the beginning. For me, the riskiest time is when I put something in the kiln and it stays in the kiln for a week. And then once I open it up, it's kind of like a make or break moment. Sometimes it hasn't worked. Like, there's a 40% chance of failure. So you would, as soon as you open it up, you're like, oh, something feels wrong. The door's a bit heavier than normal. Maybe there was a bit of glass sticking to it. And then you open it up and you sometimes see like a crack in this mold that I've been working on for like 3 weeks. And then there's like a puddle of glass that's flowed out. But other times you open it up and everything's all stable and you bring it out and it's kind of like unwrapping present. So I really enjoy those moments in glass. So it's a process that brings a lot of joy and frustration. And I have to say I do enjoy both of them because it kind of highlights how interesting working with the medium is. It's also, I find it like it's molding me as much as I'm molding the glass. Because when I first started off working with glass, I was like really impatient. I wanted it to do what I wanted it to do. But like eventually I found that I've just got to work with, I've got to like let go a bit and let some of it like be a matter of chance of what the glass wants to do, and I've managed to kind of, I think it's kind of made me a more calm personality. It's softened off my rough edges.